First of all, I'd like to thank you for watching this tutorial. It's by myself, Greg Devlin. I'm a part of the Red Slick forums. I'll give you an address at the end of the tutorial. Why don't you come along and see what we're all about? Okay, what I'm going to do is the Sin City effect. Basically, what I'm going to try and do is I am going to make one of the colours primarily stand out and everything else in black and white, just like the Sin City film. I'm going to use a couple of clips from one of my favourite films, 300, because I'm sure it'd be cool with the red cloaks. It will really stand out. So what I'm first going to do is I am going to drag my clips up to the timeline. Okay, so the first clip I'm going to drag up there, and as you see in the preview window here, it pops up. I'm going to make it bigger though, because it's only a small clip, so I'm going to make it bigger. It makes it easier to work with. So I go up to the top, to the end of the clip, press Control, and then drag your clip out a little bit. I'm going to do exactly the same with the second clip. Drag it up to the timeline, press Control, and drag it out. It's just so I can work with it better. It's not the length of the clip that we need to worry about, it's the effect that we can obtain. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go to the bottom here, if you can see where my mouse is, and I'm going to go to the Video Effects tab. A lot of people will right click on the clip itself and go down to Add Video Effects, which is cool. I just like to do it this way. I like to keep everything in the screen. Okay, so this for this tutorial, I'm going to go to the bottom here, pick Video Effects. And as you can see, all your effects will pop up at the side here. The effect that we're going to use today is the Color Corrector Secondary plugin. So I'm going to drag that to the first clip, and it will pop itself down here. On my edition of Sony Vegas, it pops up down here. What you'll find on different versions or different configurations of Sony Vegas, that you might get a separate window pop up. Mine doesn't, it pops to the side, and I just have to open the screen so I can see it better. First thing I'm going to do on the Color Corrector Secondary is I'm going to go to the saturation here. Okay. I'm going to lower that as far as it can go. As you see in the preview window here, everything's gone black and white. Okay, so that's the start of the effect. I'm going to scroll down here, move across, and I'm going to invert the mask. Inverting the mask will put it back to colour. Okay, this is giving us the option so we can pick what colour we want as a primary colour apart from the black and white. I'm going to pick the colour picker here, and if you see the icons changed, I'm going to drag it over into the preview window here and click on the colour that I want to be the colour that stands out apart from the black and white. So obviously it's going to be the red cloak. So I'm going to click there, and as you will see, it is turned black and white. Okay, apart from there's a little area here where it's kept a bit of the red. Okay, so now I'm going to go over to the limit luminance. So I'm going to limit luminance low. I'm going to put it as low as it can possibly go. The limit luminance high, I'm going to put it as high as it will possibly go. Nothing much has happened. There's a bit more red showing on the cloaks there, but that's basically about it. I'm now going to scroll along here, and I'm going to the limit saturation. Okay, I'm going to the limit saturation low and put it as low as I it can go. I'm going to go to the high and put it as high as it can go. And as you see now in the preview window here, that basically everything else apart from the red aspects of the movie is gone black and white. And basically that's the effect. So quickly, I'm going to do the second clip. So again, I'll go to the Color Corrector Secondary, drag it to my second clip, it will now bring up exactly the same but panel but for the second clip. And as you can see here, I'm going to move it to the, sort of the beginning of that clip, and I'm going to do exactly the same again, saturation as low as it can go. I'm going to move along here and invert the mask, go to the color picker, I'm going to pick the color I want, obviously it's the red, and what that's going to do is turn everything else apart from, well, everything else is going to be black and white, and as you can see there, there's a slight bit showing of the red, just to show you that that's the color that we want to be the primary color apart from the black and white. Again, we go to the limit luminance, put it as low as it can go, the limit luminance high, and put it as high as it can go. And again, as we did in the previous clip, I'm going to go to the limit saturation, put the low as it can go, and put the high as it can go. And as you can see, the cloak here is pretty much all in red. And that, basically, ladies and gentlemen, is the SimCity effect. It's quite simple. In fact, it's very simple, but the effect is awesome. Thank you for watching the tutorial. I'll show you a clip now of how we have a before and after clip. And don't forget, come and join us at www.redslate.co.uk/forums. The forums are open on the 15th of November this year, but we are taking members at the moment. I'm Greg Devlin. Thank you very much.